Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. As-salatu was-salamu ala ashraf al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa al-baytihi wa mattaba'a sunnati ajma'in. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Qala Allah tabarak wa ta'ala surat al-Nisa. Inna Allah ya'murukum an tuwaddu al-amanati ila ahliha wa idha hakamtum bayna al-nasi an tahkumu bil-adl. Inna Allah ni'ma ya'izukum bih. إن الله كان سميعا بصيرا كما قال عز وجل شانه إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم ولا تنقضوا الأيمان بعد توكيدها وقد جعلتم الله عليكم كفيلا إن الله يعلم ما تفعلون صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم والعاقبة للمتقين ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given us this beautiful Jumatul Mubarak in this time of our life to come together to this masjid in Elizabeth to do the zikrullah as I recited the ayah from Surah An-Nisa and Surah An-Nahl. This is, today is the topic about Adl, the justice. I'll try to be brief with that, inshaAllah ta'ala. As I recited, it says, indeed Allah is command you that do return, that deliver the trust back to the owners of it, to the owner ahliya, ila ahliya. Whenever we take anything from anybody or have trusted upon anybody, we should return the trust to the owner of it. And when you are being called to do the judgment, فَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, among the people to do the, deliver the justice, be jury, أَنْ تَحْكُمْ بِالْعَدْلِ. So do the justice, be the judge fairly with the adl. And adl and insaf are two terms which are used in system in Islam, and Quran talks very clearly about it. Adl is the justice to be served, and insaf is the equality. Insaf is the fifth. Insaf comes from nis. Nis means half. So somebody who divides equally is insaf. Sometimes justice is not equally divided. Justice to be served to the person's satisfaction, and whatever has been wrong done to the person, inshallah, I will be able to recite some ahadith in the surface. Inna Allah ma'amma ya'azakum bihi. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonish, warn you in this matter. Inna Allah kana sami'an basira. Indeed, Allah is all hearing and all watching. Allah is hearing and watching. So know that whatever we do, Allah is listening and Allah is watching. This is one of the two attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are mentioned in this ayah. So whenever we do justice, not thinking that Allah cannot hear our justice, Allah cannot see what we do to the people in matter of jury and in matter of serving the justice. Why I chose this topic today? We know in our country, in United States, there is a Supreme Court judge have died. Another Supreme Court judge is to be appointed. We Muslims think it's not part of our dealing with the government. But justice is a necessity of every human on the planet. So even though as much as we feel ourselves disenchanted and distanced from the system, we also should not forget that it will be serving us too. And every single citizen of this country. As we know, the popular statement of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, a kafir government can happen. A kafir government can succeed, but an unjust government or ruling cannot survive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, there will be a few of these very important to be heard and listened, which might enlighten us that how important being honest and judicious in our matters of everything from birth till death, from morning to night and night to the morning, how we judge and deal with our affairs, because we are judge in judging ourselves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Nahl reminds it, which is chapter number 16, verse number 90 and 91. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah ya'muru bil adl. Allah commands, it's a direct command, to be just, to do the justice, well, ahsan, and do the ahsan. Ahsan is something which is just beyond being a right of a person. If somebody doing ahsan is above and beyond the call of duty, Ihsan come from husn and beautifying the matters by dealing in such a way. And often we think we did it because it was my call. People pray zakat thinking it's my job, I'm done. That's a fard. Ihsan is a sadaqah above the zakat. Somebody I deal with, or a matter of family or affair or transaction or business and other things, we think equally I have done this much. But the ihsan is to be dealing with the beautification of the matter so that it will not be leaving a bitterness in the other party. And ihsan is not what I want to do on the others. Ihsan is what other needs from me. Ihsan is not, I think I did my justice. Often we do injustice in our affairs, thinking I am the judge. I am not the judge. I am a person to settle the issue in between. Commands us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are often judgmental about each other. It is very important. I am victim of and being criminal, or we all are, and not should I say, we all judge people by their appearance. Oh, this is probably is a religious and non-religious. We have seen very religious appearing person have done very wrong, and very unreligious person has done very good. So justice is something beyond the appearance, the inside of a person. Wa ita'i dhil qurba, and giving to the closest of the relative. And this ihsan is coming after the relation. In Islam, is the religion of individual, the family, the community, the collectively as a nation, wherever we are, justice is to be served. And we know that many of the countries which are so-called Muslim or even non-Muslim, in Muslim country you can find a witness outside the court for killing and saving somebody's life. Often it is, in Pakistan there was a situation, we were discussing in a situation, a person was asking me, how come all these people who have raped and murdered the children and never getting punishment, or never getting punishment and they are getting away with it, including those who have robbed the nation, cheated and looted the wealth of the nation? The justice required four witness in matter of rape. If your four men do not come forward to justice to do the witness testimony, how could a judge can condemn a criminal? It's very important yet very sensitive matter. And people do not come forward because of the fear of other hardship and threats they get about their family. So the people, when they want to come for testify, they are afraid of personal protection. That is the responsibility of the state to establish that. So if the state is not strong, the criminal get loose and the crime goes into spiraling down to the point where there is a chaos. So everybody picks up the weapon and there's no justice left to be served, because people take the justice in their hand, and that creates the vigilantism which is absolutely forbidden in Islam. Be patient, be perseverant, but be patient. Usbir wa sabir wa rabitu wa taqullah la'allakum tuflihun. So ita is al-qurba, the closest relatives. A person should start from parents, to the brother, sisters, to the spouses, to the brother, children, to the relatives, to the near relative, to the distant relative. Ita is al-qurba, giving them of the closest of the relation. This is the most important part. I personally think myself that I have more animosity towards my sibling rivalry than the other person. People go out and seek a sheikh outside, yet the parents are in home. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, whoever disrespected his parents in home, Allah will dishonor and disgrace him in the dunya, and the akhirah he will never have any of his worship accepted. So when we have our forefathers, the parents and grandparents in home to serve them, to please them, to honor them, yet we are looking for some great sheikh who have done miracles. The greatest miracle, even if they are non-Muslim parents, person have to treat them with utmost respect, except following them in their practices of worshipping ghayr Allah. Another, وَيَنْهَ عَنِ الْفَحْشَ. After the treating respectfully our loved ones, the close of the relation, abstain from fahsha, the obscenity and vulgarity, وَالْمُنْكَرِ, and denying the truth in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in Islam, وَالْبَغِي, and being rebellious from the commands of Allah and His Messenger. You see, all these things are covered in a person's life when the justice and ihsan is mentioned. In the sequence, these things are mentioned, if we could comprehend that. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكُرُونَ, so that you may remember and reflect upon this. وَعَوْفُ بِأَحَدِ اللَّهِ إِذَا أَحَدْتُمْ, and fulfill the covenant which you made and contract you made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to let go of the contract which we made, the promise with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَنْقُدُ الْأَيْمَانَ بَعْدَ تَوْكِيدِهَا. And do not break the covenant and violate the contract when you made it with the firmness. تَوْكِيدِهَا. In Arabic, when you speak to Arabic, they say أكيد. Absolutely. Sure. Firm. تَأْكِيدِهَا. تَوْكِيدِهَا. When you have made a firm, کہتے ہیں نا زبان دے دیا بس ہمارا وعدہ پورا ہوگا. یہ ایک عہد مسلمان کا عہد ایک بہت بڑی چیز ہے. اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی فرماتے ہیں تم کو حکم دیتے ہیں اللہ تعالی, حکم ہے, اجازت نہیں ہے, حکم ہے کہ عدل کرو, احسان کرو اور دو مال اپنا اپنا تمام خوش معاملات جو بھی ہیں, مال کے, احسان کے, اخلاق کے تمام بہترین معاملات ان کو دو, ان سے کرو جو کہ تمہارے سب سے قریب ہیں, قربا, اور برائی سے روکو. اور فحشی is something very infectious. I can give you my personal observation and I'm sure everybody has experienced it. When first Pakistani satellite channel start coming, like Jio and all those, they would be talking about Islam and suddenly then you have a commercial break. In that commercial break you see something which is totally contradictory to that statement. تقریر چل رہی ہے مذہب کی اور وہ دکھا رہے ہیں کچھ بہودہ اور برے لباس میں کسی کو. آپ تھوڑی دیر کے لیے غور کرتے ہیں کہ یار یہ کیا ہو گیا. چند دنوں بعد آپ کی آنکھوں سے حیا نکل جاتی ہے, پھر آپ کو لگتا ہے یار یہ تو چلتا ہے, دس از اوکے. سینگ اے ولگیریٹی اینڈ ابسرڈ, ادھر تو بول رہا ہے اللہ اور رسول کی باتیں ہو رہی ہیں, ادھر بے حد برہنگی اور فحشہ دکھایا جا رہا ہے. اور سلولی اٹ کریپس ان ٹو اس, سلولی اٹ کیٹس اینڈ ٹیک اوور اور باڈی. سو اللہ سبحان اور مائنڈ اور آئیز ڈو ناٹ فیل اینی مور. ناؤ وین وی فسٹ کیم ٹو امیرکا وی یوز ٹو بی لٹل بٹ سرپرائز لکنگ ایٹ دا لائف اسٹائل, بٹ سڈنلی ناؤ وی سے اٹس اوکے چلتا ہے سب. دس از ہاؤ دا فحش انفیکشسلی ٹیکس اوور اے پرسن. والمنکر, denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's trust and command and messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam's command for a person. تو حضور کے, اللہ کے اور اللہ کے نبی کے حکم کو توڑنا اور بغاوت کرنا اللہ کے احکام سے. Often whenever scholars and علماء say something, people say, oh, these یہ مولوی ہیں, یہ تو ایسی بولتے رہے. That word can be very important to understand. مولوی اگر کوئی سیاسی بات کر رہا تو آپ اختلاف کر سکتے ہیں, لیکن اگر دینی بات کر رہا تو وہ ذاتی مفاد تو نہیں ہوتا. We need to be very careful in matters with that. I'm speaking in Urdu because I've been ordered to speak. Some people like to understand, some people do not understand Urdu or English properly, so I speak in Urdu. وَأَوْفُ بِعَهْدِ اللَّهِ إِذَا عَهَدْتُمْ, اپنا اللہ سے کیا ہوا وعدہ اس کو پورا کرو. وَلَا تَنْقُضُوا الْأَيْمَانَ بَعْدَ تَوْكِيدِهَا, اور اپنا وعدہ جو تم نے پکا کر لیا کرنے کے بعد اس کو توڑنا نہیں. یا تو وعدہ مت کرو, جب وعدہ کرو تو توڑو نہیں. ہمارے ایک بہت آسان سا جملہ ہے جو کہ بولا جاتا ہے کہ انشاءاللہ, اس کا مطلب ہے گارنٹیڈ کہ نہیں ہونے والی. ایک عجیب سا ایک کلچر بن گیا. انشاءاللہ was supposed to be the most authentic statement of a person that by the will of Allah I will complete it. It means I am done. If Allah wills otherwise then it will not happen, but I'm going. But now we say I don't want to happen, Allah wills it may happen. That what has become the culture now. We have to be very careful with this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَدْ جَعَلْتُمُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ كَفِيلًا, and you have made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as your kafil in this contract of dealing with the people. We often mistrust our country. ہمارے ایک بڑی آسان سی بات ہے, کیونکہ اپنے ہی لوگوں کی بات کی جا سکتی ہے, دوسروں کا کیا ذکر. کہ جب کبھی ہم کاروبار شروع کرتے ہیں تو شروع میں جو کمزور پارٹی ہوتی ہے نا, وہ ہر بات کو کرنے کے لیے تیار ہو جاتی ہے. جی ایسا بھی ہو جائے گا, ویسا بھی ہو جائے گا. آپ نے کہہ دیا ہو جائے گا. جب تھوڑے دن بعد جم جاتی ہے تو پھر ہوتا ہے جی یہ تو بس جان کو آ گئے ہیں.